You can see the resurrection fern have resurrected since it rained yesterday.
These guys look dead until we get like a really high humidity or a drizzle or rain, and then they come back to life. And they usually are on trees, dead trees, alive trees.
In a few days, we're gonna have our first night in the 40s, like 48 degrees.
First, you know, I think we hit like 58 or something the other night, or we're supposed to. It was supposed to be 52. Don't remember if it was Friday or Saturday or what, but now they're saying 48 degrees. Plants or plugs that we got yesterday are all potted up in little pots and some tall pots, and we're bottom soaking them with water right now. So maybe in the next day or two I'll post a update video showing everybody what we got and how they look.
So look at the plum cot. It's getting in to be like a full bloom.
And it is not time for these guys to bloom at all.
Nice little moth there.
Check out these goldenrods. Just about opening pretty good here. And we got a really nice bumblebee there, full of pollen. Oh my lord, look at here.
The Meyer Lemon potted plant is blooming once again. This is like its third or fourth bloom cycle.
Gee, debated whether or not to just stop the video earlier and just finish the video either later today or tomorrow or over the next 3 days, but I just don't have a lot of time today. I'm fixing to leave. Soon we have to, check out all the pawpaw seedlings, suckers and stuff, and kind of get an idea of how many potential grafting unions we can put on these guys. Of course you can put them on the bigger trees, but you know, any excess stuff can just be all latched onto those trees, you know, the bigger ones. But the seedlings that don't have grafts on them, like the graft that failed here, that's where we try to graft. It was just late in the year and it didn't take. But we could probably go below there and do one and one right there. So we could probably do at least two grafts on this guy here. But since the grafting stock, Scion Wood or whatever, has 2 to 3 graftable pieces on each branch, we would just put one type, one variety on. And that makes it easier to know what is on the actual tree if you get a successful graft, what cultivar. This guy here, I have no idea what them two cultivars are. And there's an area here for a third one. Possibly a fourth one here.
Yeah, we had a root sucker there that we tried to graft and it didn't work.
We got one over here. We're back by Meyer Lemon Tree. There's another one on the other side of the Meyer Lemon Tree. So I probably only get one graftable section on this one. So if I got like one cultivar, I might have to use two different suckers or whatever to make something here. And just make sure I have a second tag made so that one, if the graft is successful, we'll know what it is. In my head, I think we'll have between 7 and 10 good grafting stock. I think I just seen a snake run through here. Yep, there he goes. Oh, ooh, there he goes back that way. Don't know if you caught that on camera. My son's in my eyes. It's a black racer.
We really did not get the amount of citronellas this year as we had last year, probably because of the weird weather. You know, probably killed, you know, 2/3 or 3/4 of the blooms.
But it's still, you know, there's probably 20 or 30 nice citronellas on the tree.
And I've learned to love these guys. You know, their first fruits weren't very good, but after a couple years, the tree matured, you know, and got into its own flavor, I guess. And a lot of people said
it tastes like burnt rubber, but these guys here don't. They're kind of just like a
grapefruit that is less bitter very, you know, more cold hardy, I guess, than grapefruit or oranges, supposedly. And definitely something that's enjoyable, at least to me. And other people have said, you know, when they compared this to this white grapefruit here, they said they prefer the citronella. This is a native milkweed. Don't quote me on that. These guys just started showing up the last 4 or 5 years or so. And we've had dirt brought into the area. And we're not really pediculturing the lawn, you know, as much over here anymore. So it could be just something that was being cut down before it had time to flourish, or it could have came, like I said, from outside sources. And guess what I'm seeing? And I had, you know, a bird or something had to have put this down here. Wow. And I was looking at that and wasn't even noticing this Suriname cherry here. So there's a seedling right there just under a pot there. Wow. The
milkweeds here. And butterflies everywhere. Moss everywhere. Let's see if we can.
Okay guys, I guess that's it for today's garden vlog. Take care.